Today we're talking about a Pokémon that doesn't need you to get its back, it actually has its own back.
Because that back is made of flames.
And it's a Pokémon that kind of looks like an anteater. Or a porcupine? Echidna?
Yet it's called the Fire Mouse Pokémon?
Hey, don't question it or you might get burned.
Spruce, that's so sweet, but it's not actually my birthday.
I know. I was trying to give an awesome fire visual, but this is the only flame the producers will let me have on set.
Well, I hope you don't set off the fire alarm.
Well, no point in letting this go to waste. Want some?
Yes? Mmm. Honestly, worth the risk. Hi there, I'm Maple.
And I'm Spruce.
Welcome to Beyond the Pokédex, where we talk about what makes each Pokémon unique from 1 to 1,000 and beyond. Today, we're talking about a beloved first partner Pokémon from the Johto region, number 155.
Cyndaquil.
And I think it's only right to fire this one up by looking at these adorable pictures of Cyndaquil. Oh, look at it, it's so cute.
Oh, don't be fooled, Maple. When Cyndaquil gets mad, it burns red hot. I'm talking flame shooting from its back.
Aw, are you sleepy, Cyndaquil? Don't you wanna just squeeze it?
I know, I don't. You surprise Cyndaquil and those flames will surprise you right back.
But that's only if you make it mad. I'll never make you mad, my little fire mouse.
Mad is the opposite of how I felt the first time I met Cyndaquil.
So, happy?
Maple, I'm reminiscing.
Oh, excuse me. Continue.
The year 1999, the game Pokémon Gold. I was a young trainer on the eve of Y2K, worried my Game Boy Color would crash when the clock struck midnight.
Y2K? More like, why were you so paranoid?
Look, the only bugs I want to see are bug-type Pokémon, okay? Speaking of, Johto was the first and so far the only region to feature the bug-catching contest.
I'm supportive of the competitors, but I'll appreciate bug-type Pokémon from afar.
Anywho, I was a mere errand boy for Professor Elm, but my hard work paid off and he presented me with three life-changing choices. Chikorita, Cyndaquil, and Totodile.
Tell me more.
That's basically the end of the story. The point is, that's the first time Cyndaquil ever appears in the Pokémon video games. Also, it's who I chose as my first partner Pokémon.
That was a long walk for a short drink of water.
That's just the first time I chose Cyndaquil. In fact, I chose it in Pokémon Gold, Pokémon Silver, Pokémon Crystal.
Cool!
Pokémon Heart Gold, Pokémon Soul Silver.
Oh wow, that's a lot of games.
Well, I'm not done yet. I also chose Cyndaquil in Pokémon Legends Arceus.
You went with Cyndaquil in all six of those games?
Yeah! Which one of those stories do you want to hear next?
I think we get the picture. You always pick Cyndaquil. And for good reason.
Yes, I most certainly do. It's one of only a select few Pokémon that gets access to Eruption. I can't pass up on that move.
That's a powerful move for a first partner Pokémon.
It isn't strolling out of Professor Elm's lab ready to erupt. You're gonna have to grind to level 64 to learn the move. But, you know, by that point, it'd probably already have evolved into Quilava and then Typhlosion.
Who wouldn't want to spend 64 levels with Cyndaquil?
Trainers who compete in video game competitions. Cyndaquil hasn't made the history books, but its fully evolved form Typhlosion made some serious waves at the Florida Regional Championship in 2015. You see, the strategy was—
Spruce, maybe we save that for the Typhlosion entry.
Right, I guess like most stories that come out of Florida, I'll spare you the details, for now.
Well, you might not see Cyndaquil in the winner's circle of a video game competition anytime soon. It's taken home some serious accolades in the Pokémon trading card game.
Oh really?
You bet. Christopher Kahn included Cyndaquil and its Stage 2 evolution Typhlosion in his deck when he won the 2011 Trading Card Game World Championship.
Christopher Kahn? You mean multiple time championships winner Christopher Kahn?
That's the one. In 2011, Christopher Kahn used Cyndaquil from the Heart Gold and Soul Silver expansion. Did you know that since its debut in the Neo Genesis expansion, there are currently 19 different Cyndaquil cards?
19!
Should we flip through the unofficial Cyndaquil TCG yearbook I scrapbooked?
Only if we skip right to the best part, superlatives.
Duh, it's the only reason to even get a yearbook.
That and the signatures page. Well, except my yearbook. I didn't let anyone sign. It will hurt the resale value when I inevitably become famous.
I really envy how you've got it all figured out, Spurs. Anyways, the Expedition Cyndaquil card was voted most likely to discard fire energy.
And from the looks of this card, it turns the battlefield into a dance floor.
The EX Sandstorm Cyndaquil is voted most likely to spray it, not say it.
And it's clearly got some hot takes.
Last but not least, the Cyndaquil Sword and Shield promo was voted most likely to need to recharge.
With what appears to be a relaxing hike through the forest.
Or just sitting in nature like this Cyndaquil seems to be doing. Why exercise when the fresh air can come to you?
And speaking of venturing through the forest, Cyndaquil is a trusted friend and partner of none other than Ash Ketchum.
I bet you want to reminisce here too.
I do. Picture this, it's Ash's first day in Johto. He's visiting Professor Elm's lab. The season, 3. The episode, 1. Don't touch that dial. Cyndaquil and Ash's meeting seems like destiny, but Ash doesn't add Cyndaquil to his squad for another 24 episodes.
I guess good things come to those who wait.
And wait, Ash does. Believe it or not, Ash's Cyndaquil took a record 507 episodes to evolve into Quilava.
Aw, they grow up so slow. When I was a kid, my grandma always told me to stay a kid as long as I can. Didn't work for me, but Cyndaquil took it to heart.
Well, much like a caring legal guardian, the reason Ash does finally catch Cyndaquil is because he was just trying to protect it from Team Rocket in the episode Good Quill Hunting.
How do you like them apples?
What Ash discovers later in the episode is that this particular Cyndaquil has back problems.
Cyndaquil, what happened to not growing up too fast?
The problem is fire-related. It just couldn't get its flames going in battle.
Aw, poor little Fire Mouse.
Sure, maybe other trainers would have ignored the issue, but this is Ash Ketchum we're talking about. Cyndaquil helps Ash develop and hone his signature trainer style.
Ooh, what's his style?
Ash gets to know his Pokémon on a personal level and trains them based on their unique personalities. After a tough matchup with a Skarmory and his challenge at the Azalea Gym, Ash notices Cyndaquil is a master of defense. So, Ash has it practice agility, a technique Cyndaquil is only ever seen using in the animated series.
Agility. So that's how Cyndaquil got its groove back.
Aw yeah. It fires Cyndaquil up for its rematch with Skarmory, and from then on, Cyndaquil's flames are back.
Its back has got its own back.
Exactly. Then Cyndaquil really shows off its newfound fighting spirit in a battle with Steelix at the Olivine Gym in Nerves of Steelix.
Hold up. I know Cyndaquil has super effective attacks in this matchup, but you're telling me Ash called on shy little 1-foot-8-inch Cyndaquil to battle over 30-foot-tall Steelix?
Down to his last Pokémon, after Steelix knocks out Pikachu with Iron Tail, Cyndaquil is Ash's final hope.
You got this, Cyndaquil.
Steelix tries to dig down and attack, but Ash has Cyndaquil spray the battlefield and walls with its super consistent flamethrower.
Whoa.
Cyndaquil is so fired up for this battle, it takes an Iron Tail hit from Steelix.
The same one that knocked out Pikachu?
Steelix doesn't stop there and sends a sandstorm tornado. But the real twist comes when Cyndaquil shoots flamethrower into the tornado, catching Steelix in a storm made of fire.
Cyndaquil uses Steelix's own attack against it?
Steelix is left unable to battle. And that, my friend, is how Ash earns the mineral badge.
And that kind of butt-kicking is what you get from Gold Cyndaquil named Expo in Pokémon Adventures.
Oh, it has a rep in the manga too?
Oh yeah, it's feisty and it runs hot. It's known for its temper.
Wow, that sounds so different from Ash's Cyndaquil. How can it be so cute but be so fiery?
After hanging out with me, do you still really need to ask that question?
And now I'm afraid to ever ask that question again.
Expo, the cute but chaotic Cyndaquil evolves into Quilava and then into Typhlosion. Typhlosion is the ace of Gold's team and has taken on many opponents like the Masked Man, Lance's Dragonite, and even Arceus itself.
So if you run into a Typhlosion named Expo, consider yourself warned.
But typically, Cyndaquil are known for being shy.
In Pokémon Mystery Dungeon Blue Rescue Team and Pokémon Mystery Dungeon Red Rescue Team, trainers who seem timid in their personality quiz are paired with Cyndaquil as their starting Pokémon.
Sounds like a match made in introvert heaven.
Hey, sometimes opposites attract. You don't have to be an introvert to catch Cyndaquil. For instance, you could go out with your squad and catch one in Pokémon Go.
Definitely.
And in Pokémon Go, you might see its shiny form and shadow form too.
Sweet.
Speaking of sweet, if you feed Cyndaquil 25 candies, it will evolve into Quilava.
When I eat 25 candies, all I get is a tummy ache. Mm.
Cyndaquil's like your total opposite, huh? Introvert with a sweet tooth.
Well, I like to think I'm more of an ambivert. And like Cyndaquil, I am also fearless in battle.
True. I would not want to get into a battle with you.
I would not hold back. But how about we leave the challenge to our trainers tuning in?
Good idea. Trainers, we've got a question for you. What is the name of Gold Cyndaquil in the manga Pokémon Adventures? Leave your answer in the comments below. And thanks for tuning in to another entry of Beyond the Pokédex.
And remember, the Pokédex is only the beginning.
Hey Maple, did you ever get any superlatives in your yearbook?
I was voted most likely to host a Pokémon video series with my best friend.
No way! That's the one I got too!
Small world!
I was also voted most likely to end videos with long lists.
Uh-huh.
Like that time in the Pachirisu entry where I kept naming different electric types.
I remember that.
Or that time I publicly revealed a bunch of my fears in the Miss Magius entry.
How could I forget?